Hello and welcome to this video. This video is basically about what it's like doing online uni, specifically what it's like studying international studies at RMIT with Ella and I. Ella's in her first year of this course and I'm in my second year. So we thought it'd be cool to just share like what we learn about, the different readings, the content, the lectures, what we discuss in our shoots, because personally I think the content is really, really interesting. And we thought it was interesting enough to make a video out of it and share it with everyone. So I hope that you guys enjoy this video. Let us know what you think. Let us know what you think about our course. And yeah, enjoy.
Welcome to a week in the life of two international studies students. My name is Ella and I'm currently in my first year of the course and I'm absolutely loving it. For me, international studies is really a course that enables me to look at a whole range of different global issues from lots of different angles, from an environmental angle, from a political angle, an economic angle. And it's just been so interesting and really opened my mind to the state of international affairs.
So, I'm currently in my second year of international studies. I'm specialising in development this year. And it's really hard to sum up what this course is because it is really broad and really diverse in the best way possible. It covers a lot of different political issues, social issues, global issues as well, and also how they intertwine and interact, I suppose.
The first is called Global Mobility and Ethnic Relations, and as part of this we are looking at migrants and refugees and different ethnic minorities. My second subject is a subject called Global Processes, which is my favourite. And it's basically a course on globalization. We've looked at neoliberalism. This week we are looking at systems thinking, which is really interesting. My third subject is global history and security, which is a little bit out of my comfort zone because I never did history at school, but it's been so fascinating and we've looked at World War I, and the Cold War, the European Union this week, and that's been really interesting. And also as part of this course, we have to learn a language, and so I'm doing Spanish, which has been a challenge to work with
online in an online
setting, but we're getting through it and it's gonna be okay.
My subjects this year are global development themes and debates, so that's a lot about international development, economic development, things like that. Another subject I have is working and managing global careers. That's all about job applications, how to appear in the workplace, CVs, cover letters, internships. I talk more about that throughout the video. Sustainable futures is an elective. Obviously that's all about sustainability and ethical consumption and climate change. Very interesting. And French. I'm in French 3 right now, meaning my third semester of French. It's really difficult, especially online, but it is a UN language and it's also a beautiful language and I love it and my teacher's great.
Good morning. It's a Monday today, so that means that I have a lecture and a tutor on one of my subjects called Global Mobility and Ethnic Relations. I've woken up a little bit early just so I can do the readings before my lecture starts.
Hello, good morning, it's Monday morning. I don't actually have any tutes or lectures on Monday. Jokes, I had a lecture that I didn't watch. But that's okay because they upload all the slides and the actual recording. So I could watch that now or later. So that's what I'm gonna do today, is just get kind of myself ready for the week, get my readings and lecture watching done, and yeah, do some work. So otherwise that's all I have on today, so I guess I'll speak to you tomorrow.
Good morning. It is Tuesday this morning and I've just finished watching a lecture in my bed for my subject called Global Processes. It was such an interesting lecture this morning, all about a concept called systems thinking. And I have my treat soon.
Systems thinking is a way of seeing the world as a series of interconnected and...
which is a way of addressing problems and looking at the world as being interconnected, like it shows here, and seeing how solutions and problems are circular and just all of these really cool concepts. I really liked this reading a lot. As part of my course, you have to do a language. And I've decided to do Spanish this semester, and I have an oral assessment coming up very soon, so I'm just practicing. It's like very, very basic, just learning how to introduce yourself, to say who you are and how old you are and where you live and what you do for work. Also like learning how to pronounce the alphabet. And yeah, it's fun.
Hello! So, it's Tuesday. I went and got my flu shot. Big girl, but my arm's sore now. And I have my next shoot in like an hour, which is for global development themes and debates, which is all about like international development and developing countries and things like that. It's really interesting. And then I have 2 hours of French. And yeah, I'll see you guys throughout the day, I suppose.
All the scaffolded stuff. Although it does become, if you can kind
of... the implications of like international NGOs.
Il existe deux sortes de futurs.
Et vous avez jusqu'à minuit.
With the struggles with it sort of thing.
G'day, I'm Barnaby Joyce. Tonight's Australian story is about a community in my electorate that is undertaking a bold social experiment.
I live in Elwood and down at the beach, it's just crazy. There's so many people. You have to like touch people to walk down along the beach.
So you can't really practice social distancing.
Not at all.
Oh, no. Like sort of just the empathy that you gain from it.
What values in employees they're like seeking and how it changes. It's like, that's so interesting. Like, what is it going to be like in like 5 to 10 years? And like, I wonder where that like shift comes from.
He's just on quirky.
Yeah. Hello. I wanted to jump on quickly and talk about this subject that I just had a shoot for. It's a second year subject. It's called Working and Managing Global Careers. And basically what this subject does is completely prepares you for the workplace. All about the best way to write and conduct your CV, your cover letter, job applications, internship applications. And today we learnt about the theory of like a growth mindset. Is that what it's called? Yeah, growth mindset compared to a closed or fixed mindset. And basically about like when going for a job, what kind of attributes or like traits different companies or organizations are looking for. Being innovative, passionate, willing to learn, open-minded, and have a variety of skill set, a variety of skills to bring to the job. I just feel like so much more prepared to apply for jobs. I think that doing an arts degree, sometimes it can get like really like broad to the point that you're like, what am I doing and where is this taking me? And I felt that a bit last year, but this year, especially with this course, it's been much more clear a path that I can take, or like, I don't know, being aware of different opportunities that are out there and the best way to go about doing them.
Good morning, it is Thursday today and I am working on a subject called Global History and Security. I have a lecture starting very soon and then a shoot after that. And today we're looking at the European Union and we're discussing what it is and why it matters. So my shoot is about to start, but I just learned so much in that lecture. Like, I actually hardly knew anything about the European Union, so Look at that, you learn a new thing every day.
And who is sort of benefiting more out of the EU, which member states have more power within it?
I'm currently working on an assignment for Global History and Security on an essay question about the Thucydides trap. And it's been really hard work, but it has made me research into a whole bunch of different things that I don't think I normally would otherwise. I've been looking into the history of the Peloponnesian War, and also looking at the era of all of the Chinese dynasties, which is really interesting. And I'm also going to be researching a little bit into how the Thucydides trap relates to World War I, and eventually what it means today with the growing tensions between the US and China.
Hello, it's Thursday and it's 3 minutes to 12:30. At 12:30 I have a French class for 2 hours. French is split into two classes. On Tuesday I have 2 hours of more grammar, and then on Thursday I have 2 hours of like more about like culture and vocab and history and those kind of topics to do with French. So a lot about like French news. But yeah, I gotta go to French now. So see ya.
Bonjour Serena.
Bonjour.
Raphaël, oui, n'oubliez pas de me dire un petit bonjour dans le chat, s'il vous plaît. Merci.
It's Friday today and I don't have any classes, so I'm just working on assignments today. Hope you enjoyed, everyone. Bye.
It's Friday. We made it to the end of the week. I don't have any tutes or lectures on Fridays. Fridays is one of my days off, actually. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed hearing about what Ella and I learn in our course, both first year and second year. We're both really passionate about it. So if you want to know more about the course details or about what we're learning, then please reach out. I'm sure both of us would be so happy to talk about it. But yeah, that's about it from us. I hope you guys are all well, and I'll see you soon. Bye.